Hello, you.
Farmers, if you didn't have, like, without the cockerel, farmers wouldn't get up. And then... It's absolutely true. Without the farmer, obviously... Well,
without a cockerel, a farmer would go into a lifetime coma. That's it. Cockerel hasn't gone off, I'm going to stay asleep for 60 years.
Without the farmer, there is no food chain, there's no industry, there's no... You've got to look at the knock-on effect of this. You take the cockerel out, the whole of our food chain collapses.
I've said this before, I know, but the trouble with this is you genuinely believe it.
I think there's an element of truth in it.
There's an element of truth that a cockerel is nature's alarm clock. And without it, farmers would sleep for a lifetime, there would be no milk produced, the economy would collapse, everyone would die without a cockerel.
Yeah, that's it.
There's a misconception that roosters just crow when the sun comes up. Cockerels crow whenever they feel like
Absolutely,
it.
Absolutely, they crow, they know, because they've got an internal body clock.
Whenever they feel like it.
No, they just... They don't just crow whenever they feel like it. They've got discipline.
What happened there was, David said that they crow whenever they feel like it, and you interpreted that sentence as being in order to wake up farmers.
Everybody knows a cockerel crows to wake people up. They don't just crow when they feel like it, do they?
Again, there's a misconception that roosters just crow when the sun comes up. Cockerels crow whenever they feel like it.
They clearly don't crow whenever they feel like it, do they?
I've got the computer, I'm right.
All right. They have to crow it. They crow at dawn. It's nothing to do with whether
cockerels
they feel like it.
Cockerels crow whenever they feel like it.
I think you notice it more at dawn because it's quiet and you're in bed asleep.
No, that's not true. Cockerels don't crow at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't. What?
They do, Rob.
I'll refer you to...
No, they don't.
I'll refer you back to Exhibit A.
Cockerels crow whenever they feel like it.
No, they don't. They crow at dawn. They only crow at dawn. It doesn't matter where they crow at dawn. That's it. They crow. They know what time it is.
If it says it on the screen, it's true. Cockerels crow whenever they feel like it. That's it.
Yeah,
press the button. Press the button.
Do you, David Tennant, believe that cockerels crow when they feel like it?
Cockerels crow whenever they feel like it.
Do you believe that? Do you believe that?
Don't push me.
Do you believe that?
Don't push me.
Do you believe that?
Don't push me.
Do you believe that?
I know they feel like crowing.
Do you believe that?
Yes, they only crow in the morning when I get in.
Do you believe that?
It's all true. Whatever you say, I give in. I'm closing the computer. It's over.
Doctor Who is having a TARDIS. Not a TARDIS, but it's a new thing.
I've got a machine.
He's got a machine.
Yeah.
It's going to be a new baddie.
That's it.
The Magimix baddie.
And that, you know, that was, he met Edith MacArthur, a well-known Scottish actress, at that presentation.
Mm-hmm.
And Edith said at that time, someday, David, we'll be on stage together. Now, he was 11 at the time.
Wow.
They've been on stage.
A real insight.
At least twice, Dave, with Edith.
What's he talking about?
Oh, I'm talking about you.
I've got time. It's really important.
You're all embarrassed now, aren't you, mate?
Yeah. Edith.
Finding out all about you now, mate.
It's all lies. I tell you,
you're lucky he hasn't gone back to the nappy stage.
Oh,
you're
sure
you're
that,
safe.
But it's coming. If we had more than 20 minutes, I'd be
knackered. Nick, tell us.
The sense of this holy moment.
Where'd you get this kind of tramp top from?
Is this... Okay.
The fuck is... And a beard as well. Are you on the run? Is that why you just want to hide it for a couple of hours?
When I turned up tonight, you're all dolled up. Look at you all.
I know, but look, I know
and
you're
Richie.
In between projects at the moment.
Look.
We're going to have to whip round for DT at the moment. It's like a homeless hobo.
I'm trying to look cool like
hobo
a young...
Hobo tenant.
I was trying to look cool like a young person, but then I saw who turned up and it was fine.
Oh, hey!
Then I realised...
Let's do it. Buckle up.
Then I realised I'm among my own. It's fine. Right, I'm going to...
It's Matt Smith, by the way, not Matt Smith. If you want to try and get the joke. All right, then let's do the pledge, please.
I will give the response and you will answer.
Well, no, you do. I told your voice a lightweight. You've had two beers. You turned into Richie.
I have never been on a stage after two beers. I don't know where I am.
This is
honestly,
a bad
the
idea.
The whole room is... We don't do this at the RSC. This is terrible.
You get the first bit. They give the response.
And six. Now I have to talk for around about a minute without hesitation, deviation, or whatever the other thing is. It's like that panel game on Channel 4, like Rory just pointed out. However, I'm going to move on and say number 7 and talk about my other favourite band, which is the House Martins. I don't know if anyone remembers the House Martins, but the best gig I ever went to was at the Scottish Exhibition and Conference Centre in about December. It must have been 1990, and the House Martins were playing, and it was quite simply the best gig I've ever been to. They split up quite soon afterwards. I don't know what that tells you about that particular event. I'm sitting in the TARDIS now, and I'm going to wind up soon, but not before I make a few strange noises with my mouth that will go somewhere along the lines of bingle bongle, dingle dangle, yickety doo, yickety da, ping pong, lippy tappy too ta. And
being in a harness for quite a long time, usually in a pair of highly padded cycling shorts to protect what dignity you might have left after 3 years of this.
Look at that. Sexy. That was brilliant! Good throw!
It's the only one, though.
Yeah, that's it. I hope we got that, because that's never going to happen again.
Amazing as that was, in many ways, we'll just have one more go. Just
put it on. I'm just sticking it on.
The catching was just slightly out frame.
You're kidding me.
Just slightly. But it won't
be now. I caught that puppy.
HD TV. Incredible, eh? Unless you have to fork out for every month. No one likes to get stung like that.
Hey, get that back, you little...
With the Premier Collection from Virgin Media, you get TiVo, a brilliant set-top box with loads of HD channels at no extra cost. Plus... And this symbol appears. Oh, that's better.
And if you want to see me eat some popcorn, you're free to stick around. Seriously, that's it. That's all I'm going to do now. Just me and the popcorn. I'm not kidding.